So, namaskar to all of you.
Now I can.
Today is the third day of our very successful 22nd Party Congress. The fourth day, I beg your pardon. The fourth day of our very successful Party Congress, the 22nd Party Congress.
It's properly
and today the agenda has been discussion on the review of our political organization report, which was placed last night by our senior Polit Bureau member, Comrade S. Ramachandran Pillai. And so far in the morning, 17 comrades have spoken on this report. Now, basically, this report is divided into three or four sections. And one, of course, is the way the party could implement the directions given by our organizational plenum held soon after the Vishakhapatnam Party Congress. So there's a detailed review, both our work at the center, at the party headquarters, as well as the way that our general thrust of the plenum to adopt a mass line, to strengthen our links with the people, to take up local, state, and national level struggles, to build up worker-peasant unity through the struggles of the kisans and the mazdoors, and very importantly, to take up social issues, the issues of Dalits, the issues of Adivasis, in the context of the huge attack on the very constitutional structure, the attack on democracy, the attack on minorities. These are some of the issues. And of course, we have, in our plenum, we had specifically mentioned the need to increase our work among women, among youth, among students. So that is one portion of the report, how far we could implement the decisions that we had taken in the plenum. Apart from that, we are also reviewing our work in the various, among various sections of people through the organizations where communists, members of the CPIM are working. And the most recent figure we have is, of all the organizations in which we are working, we now have a membership of around 5.39 crore people who are members of the various organizations among student, youth, women, trade unions, Kisan Sabha, agricultural organizations in which we are working. We now have a membership of around, which represents 5.39 crore. So it's quite inspiring to see that in the last 3 years, we have been able to develop very many struggles which have made a difference to the lives of the people, have brought some relief to the lives of the people, and at the same time have been able to project the alternative policies of the left. Our weaknesses are also enumerated in the report. The fact that although we have tried to bring 25% of women into the party, we are still yet to achieve that target. Many of the states, we had a target of minimum of 20% of youth. Many states have crossed that percentage, but at the national level, we have crossed it, but in many states, we are lagging behind. So these are some of the issues which are being discussed today. And as you know, yesterday, we adopted the political resolution of the party. I think that press release has already reached all of you. So this is the way we are going forward, and we expect to complete the discussions today. We also adopted three resolutions today. One resolution was on the demand for women's reservation. The fact that the Modi government, in spite of having a single party majority in the Lok Sabha, has failed to even list it once in the last 4 years, even on the business agenda of the Lok Sabha and Parliament, shows the utter hypocrisy of this government as far as women's rights, women's representation is concerned. And that resolution was presented to the Congress by Comrade Shurjakant Mishra, our Polit Bureau member, and it was seconded by Malini Bhattacharya. That was one resolution. Another resolution was to strongly condemn the horrific incidents of rape on children, on minors. Specifically, we had mentioned the rapes in Kathua and in Unnao. And we have said specifically in that resolution that whereas we are deeply concerned about the increasing incidence of atrocities on our children, what Kathua represented was a really horrific reflection of the kind of communalization which is happening of our polity today, when a victim is selected because of her religion, when the accused are protected because of their religion, and where the topmost leaders of the Bharatiya Janata Party come out openly on the streets inciting anger against the victim and her family and in protection of the accused. I think the national outrage on this at last made the Prime Minister break his silence, but it was too little, it was too late, and it just insulted the memory of that child, her struggle and her family's struggle for justice, and the outrage of every citizen of this country. The other resolution, the third resolution that we adopted, was on the issue of rights of the disabled and the need to implement the important legislation which was adopted on the basis of a countrywide struggle of those who are in the disability sector. And it is very unfortunate that even now that has not been operationalized, the budgetary provisions to ensure disabled-friendly infrastructure is still woefully inadequate. And apart from that, many of the states and state governments have also not adopted the rules, as a result of which, several months after the adoption of the Act, we still do not have it in operation to support the basic citizenship rights of the disabled. So these are the various, this is the what has been happening in the Party Congress today.